have seen a lots of comments on the short video which we are on the channel about, you know, quick loading animation in Figma, and lots of people are struggling to recreate that animation. So just for the request from those viewers, I'm creating this detailed tutorial about, you know, creating that cool loading animation in Figma. So let's jump into Figma and get started with it. Hey, what's up guys, welcome to another exciting design tutorial. Today we are going to create this cool loading animation in Figma. Be sure to, you know, subscribe to the channel. If not, let's start by drawing a circle. Just, you know, create an arc, any arc for now, and just, you know, create the ratio of the sweep somewhere around, you know, 75%, or it's up to you, you know, how do you want. So sweep has to be 100%, and, you know, we'll be creating this hollow circle or a ring of the circle. Make sure you are using the dimensions correctly, you know, those could be anything, because we'd be creating a component, then that component can be scaled up or down as required. So just to start with, let's have 500 by 500 pixels, and okay, cool, let's just duplicate this. Well, before duplicating that, I would, you know, rename this, let's say background, because just to avoid the confusion, and I'll give it a slightly darker color. Now let's select this, duplicate this, and now we'll be saying this anim, because we'll be animating this circle. And now I'll adjust the sweep, and before adjusting the sweep, I'll first make sure that I'm, you know, changing the color of this. I'll have, you know, something like this, a fresh and, you know, bright color. Make sure you start the sweep at negative 90, and then you have, you know, this first quarter or, you know, the top right quarter of the circle filled up with this anim object. And you can, you know, change the bar radius to make this slightly, you know, circular at the edges, because we don't want that sharp edges of the circle. And if you want to be a little bit fancy, you can add the stroke to this, and make sure you are selecting the outside. If you do inside, I'll, you know, quickly show you what is the difference. So if you do the stroke inside, then that won't be visible on the overlapping part, because that's, you know, the stroke is inside the shape. So just make sure that is outside the shape, and I'll again go back to the 2 pixels. I was just showing it to you guys. And you can, you know, change the stroke to a gradient, or, you know, that would just give you the cool effect of the stroke. So I'll just say something like this, where, you know, we have nice little gradient, and that would be more prominently visible on the darker background though. But yes, let's just have a cool gradient to the stroke. So now let's make the component out of it. Well, before making the component, let's create the, you know, all the variants which we want. But before the variants, let's right click this, select you know, both of the circles, right click this, frame selection, and that is going to be your loading animation. And I can say maybe default or first. What's I'm doing, sorry. First. Now I'll just duplicate this, and I'll say second. Now we need a third, and the last one, fourth. I know there are lots of comments on the video which we have on the channel, you know, it is not working for the people. That's why I'm making this detailed video. So just select this. Make sure you are selecting the anim layer, not the, you know, background layer, or not the complete frame. And that is the trick here, because, you know, that is the problem where most of the people are, you know, not able to follow this tutorial from the short video, because that doesn't specifically talks about, you know, which object you have to select and rotate. So make sure you are selecting this anim object and you are rotating it. So I'll be selecting this, and I'll be rotating it to the, you know, kind of 90 degrees. Then again, I'll select this. Make sure again you are selecting the anim object, and then you are rotating it to further 90 degrees from this, and then this would be the last object where this is going to be something like this. So make sure you are you have selected anim object in each frame, and you have rotated it almost 90 degrees from the previous frame, so it would be something like this. Now I'll be selecting all of these circles together, and I'll create component set out of it. So go to the create component, click on create component set, and our component is ready. Now the fun part, let's add, you know, interactions quickly. I'll first create normal interactions in all of the circles. Okay, Now let's select all these circles or variants, and now click on this, you know, interaction on the right side in the prototype. And now we'll change this to after delay for all of the interactions in single go. That will save some time. Let's create 1 millisecond as after delay, and then I'll be creating this as a smart animate, and I'll be having a linear animation curve because we want straightforward simple animation, and somewhere around 600 milliseconds. Great, that's it. Then our animation is ready. I'll just, you know, use this frame from the previous tutorial. I'll bring in this loader component here, and as I said, you know, you can scale it up down because that is a component. Make sure you hit the K and use the scale tool, not the, you know, normal selection tool, because that won't be scaling up the internal layers accordingly. So I'll just align it at the middle. I'll hit V again. I'll hit Shift E to go to the prototype, and I'll just, you know, play this prototype. And now you can see, you know, this cool loading animation is ready. And as you have this, you know, nice gradient outside, that gives you this feeling. But what we can do is, you know, we can be more creative with this, and we can, you know, change this gradient as well, or, you know, rotate this gradient as well across the frame. And you'd be seeing how we'd be rotating the gradient. We'll not rotate the gradient, we'll actually rotate the circle itself, the background circle, the same way as we, you know, rotated the internal one. So let's just, you know, do it again, you know, the same way, like the 90% of the previous frame. And like this, and again, let's just test this. So you can see, you know, this this is giving an effect of a trail, you know, kind of moving behind this loader. And yeah, that's all. That's all you have to do to create these cool loading animation. Well, I'll be creating a video where, you know, we'd be having actual numbers inside this progress bar, and that is going to be using variables in the next video. So till then, keep watching, keep learning, keep designing. Well, make sure you add your comments in the video, because that helps us to keep ourselves motivated. Yeah, that will keep us that will keep ourselves motivated. So don't forget to hit the like button, and don't forget to add the comments. Let's catch up you in the next video.